हेलो एवरीवन, आवर टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ द लिविंग पैलेट। रेवोल्यूशन ऑफ फूड इज एन इंटरेस्टिंग एज रेवोल्यूशन ऑफ ह्यूमन बीइंग। लेट अस लुक एट द जर्नी ऑफ फूड थ्रू सिविलाइजेशन। अर्ली ह्यूमन बीइंग लिव बाय हंटिंग वाइल्ड एनिमल्स एंड गैदरिंग वाइल्ड प्लांट्स। लेटर दे स्टार्टेड हंटिंग स्मॉल एनिमल्स एंड वेंट टू हंट टू लार्ज एनिमल्स विद डिस्कवरी ऑफ फायर। Early human being discovered the taste of cooked food. With human being began to grow food and settled at one place. This led to formation of societies. With the passage of time, cooking changed dramatically with the introduction of salts, spices and flavors. Moreover, the different ways of cooking, roasting, boiling, steaming, baking, made food taste so much better. The kitchen was a bigger fab with the vessels to cook in, the jars to store in, and the dishes to serve in. With the changing times, nearby home style comfort food gave way to dining out. Restaurants opened the doors in Paris, and in the mid 18th century, it is marked that the start of new culture was there. Finally, casual dinners, cafes, food trucks, takeaway. There was something for everyone. Food king make a social distance among the rich and the poor. Whereas well-off families and well-off sections dined off fine soup, meats, exotic fruits and vegetables. The poor were limited to a diet of plain bread, the occasional meat and simple beans and vegetables. Cultural identities are also expressed through food. The meaning and value of traditions came to be symbolically communicated through food. Important occasions in life such as weddings, birthdays and festivals are marked by distinct kinds of food. The history of food points to their fascinating origin that emerged from different parts of the world. Quite a number of food items actually have their roots far away. For example, tomatoes are used extensively in Mediterranean cuisines today. But until their contact with Americans, Europeans had never tried tomatoes. Most Europeans thought tomatoes were poisonous. But after some time, tomatoes were everywhere. Don't forget the ketchup. They say not one cup of coffee existed anywhere but in Ethiopia or Arabia till the 1600s, when an Indian pilgrim, Baba Budan, left Mecca with fertile beans tucked into his sash. Baba beans are now famous as the filter coffee, the latte, the espresso, etc. A native of Central and South America, coca played an important role in many ancient South American cultures. In its earliest forms, the Mayans used coca as a ritual beverage in ceremonies. Once again, the explorers of the Middle Ages went to work. Coca soon became the favorite of all. We have Indians of Peru to thank for the delightful vegetable potato. The humble potato has had an incredible journey that started with the 16th century Spanish invasion of South America. Legend has it that somewhere around 4,000 years ago in southwest China stumbled on a brew that is now the famous chai. While boiling water in the garden, a leaf from an overhanging wild bush drifted into his pot. That is known as tea. Tea came of age much later, around 6th century. The tea chest started on its travel soon, first to Japan, then to rest of the world. Tea is the second most consumed drink in the world, next to water. The intense interest in different blends and brews and flavors and aromas have made tea popular around the world, from China to Japan. The list goes on, with pantries overflowing with a fascinating range of cooking ingredients. Convenience of food like canned food, frozen foods, TV dinners were once thought to be brilliant innovations in a society that didn't have time to cook. Cities, late nights at work and the rush hour traffic ate away half of the day. People started living on processed food or a frozen meal. It was easy and all you had to do was give it a quick warm up on the stove, and if even that was too much time, the handy microwave did it in a jiffy. Not so now. Food scientists and dietitians say preserved food loses its nutrients and microwaves and chemical additives are harmful. This is not all. Food companies and fast food chains are in competition, and their best bet to sell more is to add flavors in prepared food. Butters, pizzas, shattered with cheese, deep fried snacks are easy to eat, but not so easy on health. So for some, it's back to basics. So the new trend is going back to local, freshly grown foods. There are others who say, for the benefit of humans, animals and the environment, go vegan. They have powerful arguments too. It is important to remember we are what we eat. Hence, wise choices in food are important for a happy and healthy lifestyle of everyone. Our nature depends upon our food that we eat. Thank you.